What is accounting? So when it comes to accounting, I'll brief you about what exactly it means. Accounting starts with bookkeeping. It is a combination of a lot of things. So it's basically we call it as accounting as an art as well as a science, because it requires certain rules to be followed. It requires certain system to be followed. So it's more of a scientific thing, we say, because the rules remain same everywhere. Wherever you go, they are universal. 2 + 2 is going to be always 4. Debit is debit wherever you go. Credit is credit wherever you go. So these are certain rules. Then why do we call it as an art? Because it has to be look artistic. It has to be look appealing. So a certain features of art, a certain features of science as well as. So it's more of a social science we call it as. That's why we call it as art as well as a science. Now it is a art as well as a science of recording. First thing we do recording. Then whatever we record, we classify things, so we call it as recording plus classification. Then after classifying, what do? We actually try to study things, so that studying is called as analysis. So we try to compare, we try to do a lot of things. That is called as analysis. And after you analyze things, we come to certain conclusion. That's what we call it as summarization. Like this entire analysis is going to be quite huge, so we need to summarize it into a smaller piece of information. That is summarizing. And then at the end, based on your recording, classifying, summarizing, we make certain interpretation, we make certain judgments out of that. So that is what is accounting is. So this is nothing but recording, classifying, analyzing, summarizing, and interpretation of transactions. So the important thing is what are we doing of what are we doing. So that is, we are all these things we are doing, it is about transactions. Now what are those transactions? Transactions is nothing but an exchange happening in terms of money. So we are looking at recording, classifying, analysis, summarization, and interpretation of transactions in terms of money. So transactions, if you're doing not in terms of money, we are not including. But talking about transactions only in terms of money. So a lot of things, a combination of all those things combined together, are bringing down to one particular thing that is called as transaction in terms of money, right? Now moving on, like this is very simple. You can read it out. I'm not reading this information. I'm giving you an explanation. Moving on. What are the persons interested in accountancy? There are a lot of people. Now these are called as stakeholders of an organization. So when I say who are the people interested in my business, these are all going to be like just like some names I have given: creators, employees, investors, government, general public, a lot of people. Why they're interested? Creators are invest. Now the basic question should be, who are creators? Creator is somebody who has sold out something to me. I'm supposed to pay them. I haven't paid them yet for whatever I have purchased. Let's say I purchase something from you. So you and I did not pay it yet. I promised to pay you by next month. So by the time you become my creditor, because I have to pay something to you. Just reverse of the creditor is called as debtor. If you are my creditor, so I become your debtor because I am supposed to pay. So you are supposed to receive from me. So these are conceptual things. Now these people are going to be interested in your accounts because your accounting information, or what we can say, accounting records or books of accounts, will tell them your credibility. It will tell them your solvency, your position, whether you will be able to pay them or not. So if I am supposed to pay you, definitely you are interested in knowing how am I doing, how my business is doing, right? Those are the creators, they are interested. Then employees, of course, employees are the people who are working for you. So if you are working for me, definitely you want to know whether I'm making money or not. Otherwise, how would I be able to pay your salary? So it's as simple as that. So employees want to know because they think of themselves as when they're going to get salary, whether they're going to get bonus or not, how their growth as prospect is going to be there. If company is growing, then only employees will grow, right? That's why employees are interested. Lenders, of course, the people who have given money to you, the people from whom you have borrowed the money to run your business. So if I am running my business taking money from you, of course you want to know whether I'm doing well or not, because I have to repay your money, I have to pay the interest, a lot of things I have to do. So lenders, then the government. Government is the one who is looking after taxes from everybody. So if I am in losses, if I am in debt, let's forget about the debt. If I am making losses, how would I pay taxes to the government? Because first thing I have to make profit. If I don't want to pay taxes every time, I'll make an excuse that I'm in losses. So government has to check. Government has to know whether I'm in profit or not. That's why government is also interested. Then general public, of course, anybody can be interested in anything. I'm interested in knowing whether Reliance is making money or not. TCS is making money or not. I don't have anything with it. I don't have any shares. I'm not working with them. I'm not having any. I haven't given them any money. I'm not their creator, debtor, or anything. Still, I'm interested. There are a lot of people like me, so that they all qualify to be general public. So general public is also going to be interested in a lot of things. So these are all people interested in accountancy. So we need to know, because until and unless we know, we cannot classify or we cannot say. Now, what are the objectives? The objectives of accounting are very clear, that there are two primary objectives. One is to reflect. What to reflect? To reflect whether we are making money or not. Now, that money in term, we call it as profit in accounting language. So if a company is making profit or not, if a business is making profit or not, that is the primary objective. And if they are making profit, or let's say the profits are increasing or not, if there is no increase or there are constant profits, the same amount of money you're making every month or every quarter or every year, what is the growth prospect? Will it grow or not? Or let's say you're not making profit, then is your financial position, whether it is sound or not? So that is, these are the two primary objectives. One is to know whether there is profit or not. Then the other one is to check where do you stand, how much how many assets and how many liabilities do you have. Now that brings us again to the concept of assets and liabilities. Assets are nothing but the properties that you own, the things that belong to you. Let's suppose, for example, I'm recording this video using my laptop. So that laptop is nothing but an asset for me, because I can make use of it, I can take benefit of it, and maybe I don't know how this video is going to be. So if, let's say, this video gets 1 million views, now that is how I'm going to make money. So this is an asset I'm using to make money, right? If a business uses something, that's an asset. The same way, let's say to buy this laptop, I took a loan of 1 lakh rupees from a bank. That loan I have to repay back. It's not my money. That becomes my liability. So asset is something that I own. Liability is something that I have to repay. So repayment is like a burden. If I don't repay, they'll come and you never know, bank can do anything. So at the end, it's my responsibility to repay. So that's why we call it as a liability. Asset is something that is giving me some benefit, but now it is going to be balanced. Now I have a liability of 1 lakh rupees that I have borrowed from a bank. Using the same money, I have bought a laptop worth rupees 1 lakh. So that is an asset. I have an asset of 1 lakh. I have a liability of 1 lakh. So both of them go hand in hand, assets and liabilities. They will always be equal to each other, right? That's what. And all the rest of the things you can see on the screen, or the other objectives, very simple. We'll move on to the next slide. Certain basic terms. What is a transaction? We just covered. Transaction is nothing but an exchange. An exchange in terms of money. If it is not in terms of money, we will not include it. So it should be in terms of money, and it's an exchange. That means if I am giving you something, I should also be getting something in return. For example, if I purchase a phone from you, that means I am getting the phone, and in return I am paying the price for you. You are getting the money. In return, you have to sacrifice the phone that you have, the property that you have. So anything. It's like you go to a shop, you buy a pen, you buy a chocolate. You're getting the chocolate, but in return you have to give some money. The shopkeeper is getting the money, but in return he has to give certain goods. So that is how it is. That is called as transaction. Now there is something called as money measurement. All the transactions that we record in accountancy should be able to measure in terms of money. If we cannot measure, we cannot. Let's say I say I love this person or I love this particular person. It doesn't matter. You cannot measure it in terms of money. You should be able to measure that, only you can record it in accountancy, right? Then we have goods. Goods is nothing but the things that you're dealing in. So goods will differ from business to business. Now let's say I am in a business of let's say stationery. So books, pens, pencils, stapler, all those things that you see in a stationery shop, they are nothing but goods for me. But the same stationery you purchased and you're using it to write down for your regular class assignments or whatever it is, that is not goods for you, because that's something that you're using. But for me, it's a good, because I'm selling it. Now, to have a stationery store, I'm having some furniture, I'm having some lights, all those things. Now, the same furniture, the machinery, the equipment, the computers, they are nothing but assets for me. But somebody who's selling those furniture, somebody who's selling the computer, for them, it is goods. So, goods is nothing but the product in which you are dealing in. Product that you buy and that you sell, that is called as goods. And if you're not buying, you're buying not for selling it, that means you're definitely you're going to use it, that becomes your asset, right? Sales. Something that you sell is sales. Something that you purchase is called as purchases. Now sales is always going to be of goods. Purchases is also always going to be of. If you sell assets, if I'm using this table and I sell this away, I'm not in the business of selling tables. If I am in the business of selling tables or furniture, then this will become a sales. But if this is something, an asset, I'm using it, but still for now it's useless for me, so I'm selling it away. That becomes a sale of asset. But if it is general sale of goods, that is called as sales. If it is general purchase of goods, it is called as purchases. Then expenses or expenditure. I am using something, let's say to make this particular video, I am hiring an editor. So I am using the editing services. I have to pay. That's my expense. I have to pay to somebody, right? I'm using this electricity. I have to pay the electricity bill. That is my expenditure. I have to pay the rent. That is my expenditure. So anything that you're spending on, any service you're using, some benefit you're getting for which you're paying, that is called as expenses or expenditure. And just the reverse is income. Something that you're by sales, you're getting income. So when you receive money, it's most of the time there's going to be income. There are all other options whether you're going to receive money, but income is something that, you know, you're getting benefit of. It's very simple. I'm not getting much details of expenses. You know what does it mean. Profit. If my income is more than my expenses, it is profit. If my income is less than my expenses, I am in loss. Very simple. Capital. Capital is something, let's say I start a business. To start a business, you always need to put in some money from your pocket. So as an owner, if I put in the amount of money into my business, that is nothing but my capital, right? Stock. Just like goods, the goods that are not being... See, if I purchase goods, like let's say I purchased 1 lakh quantity. Out of that, 50,000 I could sell and 50,000 I'm still holding on. That amount that I'm still holding on, that quantity that still I'm holding on, that becomes my stock, or I call it as inventory. Which I could sell, that is sales. Which I could not sell, that is inventory. Interest. If you borrow money, you have to pay interest. If you give money, definitely you're going to get interest. Simple as that. Interest is on loan or borrowing, on lending. Simple. Then asset. Just now we talked about assets and liability. Asset is something that you own. Liability is something that puts a burden upon you, right? Now, talking about assets, we have two broad categories of assets. One is called as tangible assets. The other one is called as intangible. Now, tangible assets mean something that you can see, something that you can feel, something that you can experience, something that is visible, that you can, feel it from all your senses, the five senses that you have. Let's say, for example, the phone that is there that is recording this particular video. I can see the phone. That is a tangible asset. Now, there is a software in the phone. Can I see the software? That is intangible asset. Something that you cannot see is intangible. So, something like goodwill, something like patent, something like copyright, something like trademark. These are all called as intangible assets, right? So tangible is something that you can see. Something that you cannot see is intangible. Now tangible is again broadly categorized into two major categories: fixed assets and current assets. So if a business has tangible assets, either they will have they will be fixed assets or current assets. So fixed asset is something that is fixed. That is, fixed doesn't mean fixed in a place. Fixed means permanent in the business. Fixed in the business, that does not change. For example, I'm having a store. So to have a store, I purchased a building. So that building I'm not going to change every day. It is going to be fixed. Furniture I purchased, I'm not going to replace the furniture every day. It is going to be fixed. Machinery, lights, all those things are going to be there for there with my business, at least the life of that particular thing. Like for example, a furniture has a life of 10 years. So that furniture is going to be with me for at least those 10 years I'm expecting. That is called as fixed assets. They remain fixed. They remain permanent. They remain in the long term with your business. But something that keeps on changing. Like for example, I'm purchasing goods. That is my inventory. Is it not my property? That is also my property. Am I not getting benefit out of it? Yes, I'm getting benefit out of it, because when I'm selling it, I'm getting some money. That is also my asset, but that is not fixed asset. That is current assets, because it keeps on changing. Every time there will be an inventory which will keep on more or less. There is cash. Cash is also an asset. Cash is in fact considered as the most liquid asset, because anything that you can buy or sell, it is using by using cash. If I have cash, that is also my asset, but it is current assets because it keeps on fluctuating. So things that keep on fluctuating, like data is also an asset, because a data means my money which I'm yet to receive from somebody. Let's say I am supposed to receive some money from you. So it is my money which is kept with you. So that is called as a data. Don't you call it as an asset? That becomes your current asset. So things like data, stock, and or stock or inventory, cash, all those things will be part of your current assets. Now, moving on, we'll go ahead with something called as basic accounting concepts. So there are certain concepts. The first one is called as the business entity concept. Now, what is business entity concept? Business entity concept means business and businessmen. Entity comes from the word identity. Identity means you, your identity, my identity. Like you are a different identity, I am a different identity. So it says business and businessman. That means the owner of the business. These are two separate entities. These are two separate identities. If I start a business, let's say Nirmal's store. So Nirmal is a different person. Nirmal's store is a different person. It's a different identity, it's a different entity. So business and businessman, These are two separate entities. That is what this entity concept says. And as an accountant, when we are studying accounting, we are looking it from all the transactions, all the information, we are looking it from business perspective, not business plans perspective. Are you getting what I'm trying to say? So we are always looking from business perspective, not business man's perspective. Then concept of going concern. Going concern says, see, when it comes to reality, when it comes to this physical world, when it comes to this material world as such, or physical world, everything has a life. Everything, this I have a life, you have a life, this specs I'm wearing, this has a life, this microphone has a life, this camera has a life, this computer has a life, this table, this light, everything has a life. Someday it's all going to be destroyed. But one thing is permanent, that is a business never comes to an end. It comes or it comes not, that's a different question, but that's a basic assumption what we follow, that is called as going concern, that the business will never come to an end. It will run forever, it will keep on running forever. That is what is called as going concern concept. Then we have something called as it's called as perpetual life. Then we have something called as cost concept. Cost concept means everything will be recorded at cost. You will not record anything at market price or realization cost or anything. Cost, the amount that you have paid, it will be recorded in that. It is also called as historical cost, because cost that you paid becomes historical. The moment I purchase something becomes a history, because we come to the present and then we go to the future. Whatever we have done, that is in the past, so it becomes history. So it is called as cost concept or historical concept, because things are recorded in the past at cost price. Realization concept. Realization means you should never consider anything yours until you have realized. We are not saying received, we are saying realized. Received has a different meaning. Sometimes I have realized something, but maybe I would have not received. For example, I have let's say you're taking accounting classes for me. I have taught to you, which for which you're supposed to pay fees to me, but the fees I haven't received. Does it mean that fees does not belong to me? No, that fees belongs to me, because I have done whatever I was supposed to do for that fees to be earned. I have earned that, but I haven't received it. So that means I have realized it. But what if I have received the fees, you have paid the fees in advance, still I'm yet to deliver the classes. Did I realize it? No, that is just received. Realization happens means if you're supposed to receive something, if an income you're supposed to get, it is only realized only when you have delivered or you have done your part of the business. Whatever you were supposed to do. I was supposed to take classes. I was supposed to teach you. The moment I teach you, the fees that I have earned, it belongs to me. Otherwise, not mine. Simple. Just one example I gave. Then matching concept. Matching concept says your income and expenses should go hand in hand. If I am earning some income, definitely I would have incurred some expenses to earn that income. Now these two should collide with each other, then only I will be able to get to know what is my actual profit or loss. And these, if I, let's say some certain expenses and certain incomes are going to be on a regular interval. Let's say I'm purchasing regularly, I'm selling regularly. Now something I purchased this year, should I match it against next year's sale or previous year's sale? It will not give me actual profit. If I want to know what is my profit or loss, I should be comparing my this year's purchase against this year's sale. So matching concept also talks about matching of expenses with income for that same particular period for which they are meant to be, right? That is what is matching concept. We all know how to match the pairs, right? That's what matching concept is. Now, moving on. There is an explanation, business entity concept, which is taking revision. Business entity concept means business and businessman are two separate entities. Going concern means the business will run forever. It will go forever. We are not calling it as go concern or went concern or gone concern. We are calling it as going. That means it is still running and it will run forever. It will never come to an end. That is called as going concern. Realization, not mine. I should not consider it. We have matching concept means things should match one against the other. Something what is meant for, right? So let's say for this particular video, I spent 10,000 rupees to make this particular video. Now, what is the amount I'm going to earn from this video? I should match against one another. Then only I will be able to know what is my profit of making this particular video. Getting what I'm trying to say? There are certain accounting conventions. Now, these are also accounting concepts, but they go one step ahead because they become policies. These are the conventions which people have been following. Now, those are concepts which are there These are conventions which are being followed. Now, what is the difference? The difference is convention is something that come out of practice. Conventionally, we say conventionally means traditionally. Tradition becomes by practice. So something that you do every day, automatically it will become a practice. It will become a habit. It will become a convention. It will become a policy. Now, what are these kind of policies? So we have four: conservatism, consistency. Then we have full disclosure and materiality. So we'll check one by one. What is conservatism? Conservatism means be conservative. That means be prepared. Now, actually, you can see a picture of somebody wearing a mask. Mask is something to prevent you from any kind of disease or virus or infection or anything. Now, if you're wearing mask, does it mean you're going to be affected by some virus or some disease? Prevention. If I'm wearing helmet while going to the street, I'm wearing to be ready for the street, that because I don't know, anything can happen, anything unexpected can happen. So when there comes a question of unexpectancy, we be ready. So if I'm being ready, that means we are being conservative. So in accounting, conservatism says that you should always be ready for any kind of future losses that are going to happen. So if I have given some money to somebody, there is always a chance that, you know, I may not be able to recover my money. So if I know there is a slight even 1% chance, I should be ready. I should not account for it. That is what about losses. Then just opposite for the profits or incomes. The profit, even if it has come to me, until I have actually realized it, I should not consider it as mine. That is what is called as conservatism. If I see a loss even very far somewhere in the darkness, I should start booking for it right away. But when it comes to profits, I should never account for it until and unless it has actually happened. So losses, I should always be ready. Profits, I should never account until it has happened. That is what is called as conservatism. It simply says be ready, be wear a helmet, wear a mask, take an umbrella. Those are prevention better than the cure, right? So these are preventive measures, preventionary measures. So be always preventive, always make reserves, always make provisions. That is what is nothing but conservatism, right? Now, then we have something called as consistency. Consistency means it you should be doing the same thing again and again, again and again, until and you have that consistency. Nobody will put a trust on you. So when it comes to accounting information, your accounting information becomes trustable only when certain policies and procedures you are following consistently. You do not change them. So for example, there is something called as depreciation. There are different methods of depreciation. But if I have adopted one method of depreciation, I should stick to it. Now, what is depreciation? We'll come to that. You can Google it for now. There are different methods that also you can Google. But we're not getting into that detail. We're just saying that there are different methods. Now, if I change those methods every year, that is not consistency. I should be consistent with whatever method, whatever policy, whatever rules I'm following. I should follow it again. Right? Moving on. Full disclosure. Full disclosure means whatever you're doing, whatever you're recording, whatever you're not recording, disclose it. Hiding something will not serve you anyway, so you should always disclose anything and everything that you're following and everything that you're doing. That is called as full disclosure. You should never hide anything. Now, what to hide, what to not hide, that is told by this particular concept called as materiality. Things are not visible, I can see, but you can read it. What is materiality means? Important. What is important and what is not important. If you are important to me, I should care about you. That is what is materiality. So now we are not talking about people, we are not talking about emotions, we are talking about information. So materiality talks about what is material and what is not. So now that's a very subjective concept. For example, for me, even let's say 100 rupees I'm losing, that is important, because maybe that 100 rupees I'm going to use it for my lunch or my dinner. I have kept it for my dinner. If I lose that 100 rupees, maybe I'll have to be hungry. That is called as materiality. But for you, that 100 rupees would not make any difference, because you have crores of money. You can take another 100 or 1000. Would it make? Jokes apart, let's say 100 rupees for you and me, or let's say 1 lakh rupees. You lost 1 lakh rupees. It is going to be a matter for you. For me, it at least is going to be a matter. 1 lakh is a big amount for us. But let's say Mukesh Ambani loses 1 lakh rupees. Would it affect him? Not at all. So that same amount, for us, it is very important. It is material. For Mukesh Ambani, it is not material, because the value has changed. So for business to business, if it is a small business, if it is a bakery, if it is a pan shop, it is a local store, for them a transaction of maybe 1000, 2000, it is going to matter, because that might be the entire day's sales for them. But even a value of 1 lakh or 10 lakh or let's say 1 crore also for companies like Reliance or TCS will not make much of the difference, because for them it's like one transaction or maybe a fraction, a part of one transaction. It's not even one transaction. So that doesn't matter. But what if you have been put upon a penalty of even 100 rupees or even 1 rupee of penalty? That becomes, doesn't, because when it comes to penalty, when it comes to fines, we are not looking at the amount, we are looking at the consequence. You're paying penalty because you have broken some law, you have done something wrong. So there it is your act which becomes material. That is where it's a question of prudence, it is a question of judgment, where you need to understand, where you need to come up with whether what is material or what is not, that you have to determine. Now I know this video became much longer, but this, trust me, this is my first video I'm recording for accounting. I don't think I have recorded any video for accounting so far. I have been teaching accounting for last 6-7 years, still I did not record anything. This is the first time I'm recording. I don't know how it has turned out to be. Now you let me know how it has turned out to be. I'm stopping this recording for now, because I believe that's more than enough, or long enough I should say. For watching, give a thumbs up if you liked it. I hope you liked it, because staying up until here, yes.